And as always, stay beautiful. That's what you would have heard if I was recording. Good morning, you beautiful people. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day today. Welcome back to another episode of my Minecraft experience here in my Minecraft single player world. Starting things out right away with a whole bunch of spoilers. Please be, you're not ready. Of course, because I just bred you. It's okay. It's all right, donuts. We cool. Last episode, y'all didn't see. I'm gonna say it now. Y'all didn't see last episode because Donuts is a bad YouTuber. So last episode, we did all this. We did all of this. We put in some water here and it froze over. Really cool. We got rid of this little thing. I have some plans for this. I want to build a nice little bridge right here. I think that could be so cool. So cool. Maybe even utilizing that. I don't know. Ooh, what if we put like snow right there? Ooh, that might be nice. Let's try that. Let's go get some of that. But yeah, I recorded a whole episode where we did a whole bunch of cool, fun stuff. Didn't work out. I'm just a scrub. Apparently, I have to like record and in order to actually record all of this stuff I'm seeing. There's a little thing right there that shows me whether or not I'm recording. I'm recording right now. This time I am, but yeah. Also, finished up this area, at least the walls inside here. You can see I put in some pumpkins, got some paintings. Paintings are a dream, by the way, here in the latest snapshot, because you want a 2-tall painting, bam, just block it off, boom. It will take over the largest size painting that will allow, which is awesome, because now you can predict and more adequately put on paintings. It was a breeze to put on all of these paintings. It was great. So great. And you can see what I've got going on here for the red carpet. Obviously got that all done. Got the ceiling all done from last episode. Got some of these labeled here and there. But more importantly, what I did was I completed this area. Pretty simple, pretty boring in my opinion. Kind of want to do something to spruce it up, but we've got a nice little archway right here. You can see that's kind of the earth tones that I was going for when building this place. It was kind of to mirror that a little bit, but I think this looks rather nice, and I really like how the snow looks on it. I really like that. I really do. I can't wait for it to rain or snow in here, because that is gonna look really nice. Oh yeah, look at that. I think that looks really nice. But another thing we did in the episode that you guys shall never see is that I put this little fence in right here, and I changed all of this stuff from rock to from stone to grass. Whew, excuse me. I am still sick, still not feeling 100%, still coughing a little bit. You guys still not ready to breed. Okay, all right. Well, yeah, I like this this spruce wood with this cold area. I think it's gonna look really nice. Obviously something we need to keep in mind is that it's gonna snow here, so this is gonna be covered up in snow, except for the torches or the inevitable glowstone, which we're probably gonna put in this episode. Now I want to put some glowstone in, as well as some like coarse dirt. Maybe we'll put in some podzol. I don't think that's gonna be the best, in my opinion, for us to get here. But it should look nice. I want to put some glowstone with some What do you call it? Leaves. Yeah, with some leaves just hiding the place, which I think will look pretty nice. But it's not going to be just a fence. I want to add in sort of a stall area like we have. Let's actually go down here and kind of show you what I'm thinking, because I was kind of planning it out in creative mode a little bit earlier. I really, really adore and love this little horse pen house right here. Really nice, really gives you an outside-ish feeling, like we are still outside, but it gives you some shelter, which is really nice. I really like that. So I'm thinking about just kind of, I guess, just copying this exact design all the way over where the sheep are right over here. just to give them a little bit of cover, a little bit of cover from the snow when it does snow, and just to make it a little bit warmer here, which I think could be very beneficial. Really, really nice. Oh, of course, last episode that you guys saw, we died and we lost everything. Luckily, we have an overpowered gold farm as well as a lot of good enchants, so I was able to somewhat get everything back. Now, one thing I am devastated, and I mean devastated over, is our shears. We had Silk Touch on our shears, which you can't do past 1.9. And I'm so sad because that was like the thing that I absolutely adored. I love those things that you have in Minecraft that you can't do in Minecraft anymore, like those shears, which is pretty cool. But yeah, we have our Smite 5 axe back again with fortune mending, all that stuff. We have a glazed pickaxe. I think we had that left over. I got a Silk Touch shovel again. Need to put efficiency on this guy, efficiency 4 on that guy. We had an extra chocolate covered bow, but most importantly, we got our Sword of the Spirit back. Whew, thank goodness, because that was our first diamond sword that we had and we lost. But as you probably noticed there, we were able, I completely forgot about this feature here in 1. Is it 1.9 or is it 1.10 or 1.11? When was it? I think it was 1.11. You can see we have the sweeping edge effect, which means that the whole like whoop, sweeping edge effect that we got, the whole area of effect damage is going to be, I believe, because it's 3, I believe it's going to be the same damage to all of the mobs involved, which is going to be awesome. That is going to be so effective and so good, especially for the like rabbit farm and that sort of stuff, which I should go test that out. That would be pretty cool to go test that out. Really cool. We've upgraded our sword from losing it, so I guess wasn't all that bad. We don't have any backup gear anymore. I was able to get a whole new suit going on. We got that Phazon Metroid suit going on here. Put Thorns 3 on my pants, which is really cool, really nice. Everything is as perfect as it can be. Hey, you best not be escaping. Best not be. I don't think it can. I don't think so anyway. No, I don't think so. But yeah, so that's that. That's what I did in between episodes, I guess. But yeah, so there's that. Anyway, we have plenty of stuff to do. Just because I accidentally didn't record last episode doesn't mean we've ran out of things to do. First of all, I am actually kind of curious if the sweeping edge is going to be effective down here. Hopefully we have some bunnies waiting, right? Yeah, we do. Perfect. One thing that I... Ooh, this is also going to be... Oh, yeah, awesome. Those slimes are pretty weak. One thing that I did want to mention this episode is the response. Let's see. Ooh, baby. That's wonderful. I wonder if you just missed the whole thing. That is just great. Oh, yeah. Awesome. Last episode that you guys saw, you guys had a wonderful, oh, that's so great, a wonderful response towards my little divorce talk, which is really cool, and I really appreciate that, because that's stuff that, I don't know, I don't really talk about all that much, just because it doesn't really come up, but I thought, you know, hey, it might be, oh, that's, this sword is so great, it might be something that you guys might be affected by, I guess, which I don't know, a lot of people are, of course, but did I just kill? Oh, I didn't. All right, but that was super close. So cool, so cool. Love this thing. Perfect. Thank you. Awesome. And that's gonna keep going, but yeah, divorce, not a fun thing, not a fun thing for a lot of people, and not fun for really any parties involved, but one thing that I did want to mention about that is Skookum said that he was a little bit younger when his parents got divorced than when I was, and that is definitely something to take an effect on somebody. That definitely has an effect on that whole dynamic, but But yeah, it's not something that I try to take as like, oh, I'm a victim of this, because, you know, it's life. It happens. It happens to us. But it's just something that I noticed and I wanted to share with you guys. And I'm glad you guys had such a positive response to that. But anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cough real quick. All right. Slowly dying here. Slowly but surely just dying here. But what I'm going to do is, hey, go on over here. Go on. Go breed. Yeah, there you are. I am going to make some more progress on, I want to get this thing all sorted out. I want to get this lit up. And I want to build in a nice little area, like I said, of that pen over here. And I think I might add a small one right here as well. Just some shelter for these guys, just so that they can have some place to go when it does rain, when it does snow, and they get cold. Maybe even a little fireplace or something. I don't know. We'll see what I can come up with. But anyway, that'll do us for... Actually, no, we're not closing the episode. It's beginning of the episode. Donuts, because you're an idiot. Anyway, that is going to do us for the beginning of this episode. I am going to get started on that. Hopefully, you guys are enjoying the series. Also going to see if I can't work on some of this stuff here, just because I think I'm really inspired right now to do all of this. So we're going to get going. I'm going to get some more building done, and we are going to be racing against the clock, but it's going to be fun. I will be right back. Now that is a beautiful fireplace. And I mean beautiful fireplace. Whew. That is going to be a huge part in this whole thing. Welcome back, you beautiful people. I hope you guys are still having a wonderful day today. I'm going to get an ender chest and put that right there, because I think we need that. But what do you guys think of this guy? What do you guys think? I think it looks pretty good. Fireplace is one of my favorite things to do. Ooh, I don't know if I like that stone back there. I don't know. It kind of fades into the background. We'll see. It's pretty simple, pretty basic, but I kind of like it. I think it's a nice little fireplace. Oh, we have jump boost too, by the way. I added a beacon out here. The beacon that we died to last episode, so it was all worth it. As you can see, I finished the floors. I finished the carpet with all the sheep that are up here, which you guys will see. Also, didn't mention, but I put in a whole bunch of furnaces right here with a bunch of blaze rods, because, of course, just in case we need a whole lot of terracotta blocks or something. Bam, right there, red clay goes to terracotta blocks. I think that goes pretty well. And then we've got concrete, which will go to regular concrete, which is really nice. We should add maybe a little secret compartment with like water in it, perhaps. Maybe something that pops from the ceiling and then goes down. And then we can just place terracotta and like or concrete and just kind of farm it. I kind of like that idea. I think that's a good idea. We might just do that. But we have some other plans for this guy. And I am incredibly excited. In fact, I kind of want to take this and we'll just put this bed over here. Just for now. Just so we have another place to sleep. However, there is something that we need to do. I've done a little bit of work, and as you can see, I've done some little details here and there. Nothing too expansive, but stuff that's good nonetheless. I want to go get some wheat for these guys, because I want to breed them. Let's fly on over here. I did put in some glowstone, but we'll get to that later. All in good time. I am absolutely loving this project. This has been a phenomenal project for me to work on. I'm so happy that we're finally going to get... Let's just take all of this stuff. That we're finally going to get a wool farm, which is going to be super beneficial for us, because we're going to be able to expand this. And doesn't that just look wonderful? I think it does. It still needs to rain and snow to kind of give it that little bit of extra layer. But I think it looks good as of now. I think what the snow is going to do, it's going to give it a little bit more atmosphere, because it looks pretty flat, and I should probably honestly bone meal some of this. In fact, I'll do that later. I'm going to let it snow first, and then I'm going to see what areas get covered up. I'm going to see what areas are melted by the lamps and all that stuff, or the glowstone, just so that we can get a better understanding of where everything's gonna lay, because I really want this to be really well done. Alright, so that's not so bad. That's not so bad. We're gonna still have some red guys, because these guys can't dye them unless they've eaten. However, we can now breed up these guys. Are these white sheep? Are they really white sheep? I mean, it's bone meal, but they look kind of gray. Is that part of the update? That's odd. Ooh, and we got some pink sheep now. I might just like leave those, because I think that might be kind of cool. Hey, has everybody gotten some to eat? No, you haven't. All right, there we go. Very nice, very good. But as you undoubtedly see, we have a new little area, like I said at the beginning of the episode, like I was going to do this little overhang here, which I think is gorgeous. I really, really like this design. I think I'm going to add, I was thinking about adding one of it to the cow farm, just because it looks so darn good. This is definitely white wool. That's very, very a weird texture here in the snapshot, but yeah, I really like the look and the feel of this guy, because I don't know, it just creates this feeling of when you're in here, you're like safe and protected from the harsh weather and stuff, and it's warm. You've got these warm lamps, and I really like it. It gives a little bit of atmosphere, and it's really nice. I like it a lot. But we do need we've got perfect. Let's go add this to the collection. Oh, that's another thing that I added. This little tune here. Listen. Huh? It's just note blocks. Note blocks are incredibly easy. Okay, good. I did add a white, which is great. Okay. Wool first. Perfect. Let's do this. We'll do that. And let's make some carpets here. There we go. Perfect. Beautiful. Getting things all stored away, which is going to be really, really nice. What was I saying before? I have no idea what I was saying before. Oh yes, as you'll notice, I need a place to store all of this wheat. So what we need to do is we need to make a smaller one of these guys over here. And I'm going to show you exactly what I think I'm going to do for it. So I think we'll make it 3 wide. So we'll go maybe here, 1, 2, 3, go to there, right? And then we will take this guy and go up 2. And I think we'll make this rather small. So maybe just 2 or 3 tall, right, like that. And then we will make this right here go up like that. And then, bam. I really like the cobblestone as a foundation for the wood. I don't know why, but it just makes it feel a little bit more sturdy. And we need some red hardened clay, which is good for us because we are right here. A little bit of building on camera stuff you guys really don't get to see all that much, mainly because I'm busy and I don't always have time to record, but I've got a little bit of time here in the morning just to sit back, relax, enjoy some Minecraft. Awesome. We'll bring this guy up like so. Take it down. Perfect. Now, this is where we'll add some chests and stuff. I think that's going to be really nice. Do I want to bring it up a little bit? Let's head on up here and let's add in some of this stuff. Perfect. All right. I love this color combination, especially here in the taiga biome. It looks really, really nice. Or the extreme hills. It's kind of like a taiga as well, but we'll take this guy as well. Do we have room for that? Sure. Why not? We'll take some of that as well. Bring it on over here. In fact, could we do that? I don't know if I want to do that. There's no real point for a crafting table not to be put there. And then let's go like so. Hello. Sheep already loving what we're building. We'll make some more slabs like that. Perfect. And then hop on. I think I can make this. Yeah, I can. Awesome. So that is the basic design. Definitely want to add an overhang to it like so. That's going to look a whole lot better. Awesome. That looks great. In fact, I think we are going to keep it just like so. That's basically what I did for this guy. But then we will also, or do I want to bring it out at all? No, because this is like, well, let's try it. Let's bring it out Bring it out maybe a little bit. We'll take it maybe 1, 2, 3, and then take it like so, and go up maybe one more. There we go, perfect. And then we'll go like so, like this. We'll go 3 out, just a little bit of an overhang as well. We need some more of this. Can I reach the crafting table from here? I can, look at that. All right, boom, like so. This I feel like might be a little bit too big, but it might not be so bad in the end. So we'll hop on down here, go up 3, and we'll see how that looks. Well, I don't know. I feel like that's a little much. You know, I feel like this guy really does a good enough job to really get us that overhang indoor feeling, and this should really just be kind of like an outdoorsy feel for like just the wheat and stuff to breed them. I don't feel like it should be like an inside area or anything. It should just be outside, exposed to the elements. So I don't really feel like this is all that necessary. There we go. Look at that. Not so bad. Perfect. Grab you. And then I want to make some more chests. So let's do that. And we'll make some chests. Obviously, we'll make one of these go all the way to the top. And then maybe just one more. Right, like so. This is just for decoration. I find it really interesting how the sheep will find that one block you want to move or adjust, and perfect, and just go right for it. But then we'll go like so, put some wheat down like so, some hay bales. There we go. Very nice. That was my Discord going off, but I think that looks really nice. In fact, what I would like to do, what we could do, let's actually do this. Let's do this, beautiful people. Let's head on here, and I want to add just a little bit of coarse dirt. Now, I don't know if I want to add this to the entire place, because I do want the sheep to have enough wheat to grow, but I think this is going to be a nice little detail for us over here. All right, and then we'll go like so, bam, we'll make you coarse dirt. You just, as if the grass over here was so delicious because of this wheat, that they just couldn't help but eat it. I really, really like that. I think that's really nice, really cool. We'll put the wheat up here. Very nice. One more thing that we need to add, just to make it look a little bit classier, a little bit better. Oh, I didn't even talk about that pathway. That pathway I am in love with. I was originally going to have, like I said a couple episodes ago, an ice bridge. I wanted a bridge starting here to go over the ice, and it being like packed ice. In fact, that's an idea, Donuts. Let's do this. We got Silk Touch, right? Let's do this. Like, as if we've walked here so much. Yes. Beautiful people. These are the little details. These are the little details. Oh, that makes it so much better. That makes it so much better. Look at that. That is so stinking gorgeous. Oh no, I'm trapped. I'm fine. Look at that. Huh? Gorgeous. I love it. Oh, that's so wonderful. That's so wonderful. Let's sleep. Let's sleep real quick. A little tune. This place is coming together, beautiful people. I am eager and excited. I have an idea of the means of which I want to get to the secret hidden underground sheep farm, as well as get back up, but I want to save that for later. You guys might not even know that I want to do that, but that's kind of like my thing here in this world. I love making the secret hidden underground stuff. Hey, be nice now. There we go. We'll take you down. Whoop, and then drop down like so. Bam, bam. Get the grass. Beautiful. Oh, also we need some bricks in here. So let's take one of you, go like that. You go up here, maybe you up here as well, just to add some little details in. That looks nice, that looks nice. It's kind of difficult to do with like just a little thing like that, but I think that looks really nice like that. That is gorgeous. I love it so much. So that is basically all of the stuff that I wanted to get done this episode, because now all we need to do is as well, we need to organize everything downstairs in the storage room, but I think that's gonna take some time. But now we need to move on to phase 2 of the sheep farm. Obviously, We have this sheep farm, right? This is like your basic standard. Okay, it's sheep. You can get shears, but beautiful people, if you've been here with me longer than a couple months, you know that I don't just stop with this basic overworld stuff. Like, no. We need some secret hidden underground areas, and that is what we are going to get working on. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed this little episode, little bonus episode here, it feels like. But this is gorgeous. I absolutely adore this. I think this is wonderful, and I am so happy that I got this all fixed up, ready to go. I'm loving the sheep farm, love farms, loving Minecraft right now. Got a whole bunch of good content for you beautiful people that you hopefully enjoy. Really, it's the little details that make this home. So thank you guys so much for watching, and until the next absolutely beautiful Minecraft morning, I'll catch up with you guys later. And as always, stay beautiful.